You can now support my channel by using star code Kristen when purchasing Robux or Premium. Make sure to subscribe and of course ring that bell, turn those notifications on so you don't miss my next video. Hey Crypto Crew, it's Kristen and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. So for today's video, we are going to be doing one of my most requested tutorials here today on my channel. And we are going to be going over how to create some super easy beaded door ideas in your homes. Now this actually comes from the collaboration that Megan Plays and I actually did. The video is actually still up on her channel and mine as well. And a lot of you guys seen when Megan did the beaded door. How in the world did she create that? And she actually has been tagging me to do a tutorial on it. So that is what we are going to be doing for today. So of course, make sure to check out the Critter Crew B and also Super Quiet Book Bag that is over in the Roblox catalog. I will make sure to leave a link pinned down below. So with all of that said, you guys, let's just go ahead and begin our tutorial. All right, you guys, so I ended up just kind of making a temporary room of doors just so I can show you guys a couple different ways that you can actually create these. So what you're gonna wanna do is, this is going to just work for any of your doors, or even if you create your own rooms like I do, and you just need to make things a little bit fancier. So first thing that you are gonna wanna do is place a barrier behind that empty door. So this is just going to give us a little something to kind of hook the beads onto. Next, what we're gonna do is go over into the cute section, and then you're gonna see there is actually three different types of signs. So this kind of is a personal preference. So if you guys want one that looks a little bit wooden, one a little bit more modern, or if you guys want one, or like if you want your beads and door to glow, you can use the neon one. Now keep in mind, we have $125, $150, and $200. And for the first door, we're gonna need four of them, which is $800 for a door. So like I said, this is definitely one of those luxury decoration type of items. So what we're gonna do for the first one is we are gonna pull four of those welcome signs out. I'm just gonna keep this one purple for now, but of course you guys will be able to make this any color that you want. So next, what we're gonna do is actually just speed this up and add a bunch of periods. So we're gonna do 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, that should be fine. Actually, let's do 9. And yeah, I think we'll do that for all of them. So then we'll go over and we'll just paste 9 of those dots over into all of them. So next, what I'm gonna do is actually change the grid size to small, just so that we can move it around a little bit easier. And then we're just going to pull this over onto our door. So this one, like I said, I am only using 4 of them. You can make them like as thick as you want. And of course, put as many as you need. And then we're just going to put them like that. Then just kind of remove the barrier, and there you guys go. You have your little door for your beads. So you can actually walk through them, absolutely no problem, and they glow from both sides. So that one is just the super, super easy one that you guys can do. And then we're gonna just place the barrier behind once again so we can do another type of bead. So once again, I think this time we are gonna choose the cheaper one, the modern sign. This one is $150. And once again, I think we will just place 4 of them. So I think I'm gonna change the color on this one as well. Uh-oh. We're gonna need to get some bucks. I am a little bit broke. Okay, so we have some bucks in here. And then, okay, so we're gonna pull out 2 more. I think I'm gonna change the color to maybe some yellow. I think yellow or blue would be cute. Okay, so for this one, what we're actually going to do is just do some dotted lines. So I think we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think we'll do 8 of the dotted lines. And then, oh, I think that one might be too big. So let's take 2 of them down. And yeah, I don't like the black one. So I think we'll change the color Let's make this one actually blue. Okay, so we're just gonna make all of these blue, and then I accidentally changed the brick, of course. Okay, so blue, and as you guys can see this one, you can already see like how that line is working. So then we're just gonna go over and change the text. There we go. And then once again, we are gonna change that grid size down to small so that we can just kind of place these however as close as we want or as far apart as we want. So you can do this, like any of these ideas, you can do them even if you wanted like the straight ones and you wanted them to glow, you definitely can swap that out as well. So there is the second one, super easy peasy. And you can just kind of walk through that one as well. Very, very simple and easy to do. Okay, so then what we're gonna do is actually just place our barrier once again. This one, I think I'm gonna do the glowing one once again because I actually just really love the glowing sign. But we're gonna make this one a little bit different. So we're going to place four of these. Now keep in mind, once again, they are $200 each. So we have another $800 door. This one's a little bit cheaper. That one was $600. This one is $8. And let's change this one actually. Let's do yellow for this one. I think that would be cute. So let's just change that color up. Actually, let's do pink and yellow. So we'll do purple and yellow. Okay, good, we have daytime. So let's go over. So this is when you can start swapping things around a little bit, is you can even do some squiggles. Ooh, I love that one. I think that one might be like one of my favorites. So you can do your little squiggles, add them in. The next one. And yeah, so we have this one which has like the pattern of colors, and I personally just think this one looks the best just because, oh my gosh. oh my gosh, okay, there, we have that one put back. So we're gonna do pink and yellow. So if you are doing like a black and white home only, I think this would look so cute as like some doors. And then we're just going to move the barrier out of the way. So there's another super easy way to make them. And once again, you can see them like all from the back. So far, three simple ones. Now, the last one that we are going to do, I think we're just going to put four of these up. We're going with the modern ones. I don't really use the wooden basic one or wooden basic, the wooden rustic one that often just because it's not really my personal style, but I do still think it is really cute. But for this one, we are gonna use that modern one. So I'm gonna change the color. How about let's do purple and blue. Yeah, I think this one's gonna look really cute. And then we have, that's fine. Actually, I'm gonna make this. Ooh, I love that, kind of like a mermaid. Okay, so for this one, what we're actually going to do is this one, we are going to do a dash and a circle, just like that. And then copy, oh, I think I might've added too many on that one. I think the O's are just a little bit extra big on that one. Yeah, I think that one will be fine. So you just wanna use lowercase O's. And then let's just go ahead, add these ones on. And the last one, change your grid to small. And once again, just kind of like add these however that you want. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna do a little twist it a little bit, and then we can pull that down and then twist it around and then just put that like that. And move this one. Oh, that one looks really cool. This one actually was a little different than I had planned, but this one, again, you can walk through them, see them from every angle. I think that one is like so funky and quirky. Which one of the four so far, you guys, is your favorite? 1, 2, 3, or 4? All right, Critter Crew, well, that is everything for today's super duper easy tutorial. Definitely make sure to let me know which was your favorite of all of the simple, easy doors that we created and today's tutorial. Now, of course, if you guys do any of these in your homes, make sure to tag me on Twitter or Instagram because I would absolutely love to see how yours ended up turning out. Make sure to give today's video a very, very big thumbs up. It always lets me know you guys did enjoy. And hopefully, I'm gonna see you all next time. Bye, guys.